Hello kids, how are you? I hope you are all doing well. Today is we are going to start chapter number 6, that is different kinds of houses. Do you know there are several types of houses? Let's revise. Color this house beautifully. Here you can see a house and you have to color it beautifully. Now let's begin. People live in different kind of houses. A house protects us from heat, cold, wind, dust and animals. The types of houses people live in depend on the following factors, and those factors are climatic condition of the place, materials available at the place, economic condition of the people. Now let's see the climatic conditions. Houses in hot regions. In hot regions, climate is generally hot in summers and cold in winters. People generally make houses using bricks. These bricks are sometimes coated with mud and straw to keep them cool. Houses in hot regions have thick walls and high ceilings to keep them cool in summers and warm in winters. Now, houses in cold regions. In very cold regions, people build wooden houses and cabins. They have sloping roofs so that snow and rain can slide off easily. Roofs are generally made of wood to keep the house warm. In Arctic and polar regions, land is covered with snow throughout the year. The houses are made of blocks of ice. Such houses are called igloos. Now, the fascinating fact is, igloos have a dome-like structure. They are lined with animal fur from inside. Now, it's time to find out what are temporary houses. Let's learn houses in rainy regions. Some areas receive heavy rainfall throughout the year. Such areas are prone to floods. Houses in these areas are built on stilts and raised platform to protect them from floods. These houses have sloping roofs which allow the rainfall to slide off. Here you can see. Now, materials available. Houses are generally designed based on the material available in that area. Towns and cities. Materials like bricks, sand, cement and wood are easily available in towns and cities. People living there make pakka houses by using these materials. Such houses are very strong and have many rooms. Bungalows, multi-storied buildings and flats can also be seen in cities. Now, villages. In earlier times, only materials like wood, straw, mud and bamboo were available in the villages. People living in villages made kaccha houses by using these materials. These houses were not very strong and had only one or two rooms. Nowadays, materials like bricks and cement are available in villages too. Now let's do the activity. Collect or draw pictures of various type of houses and materials used in them in cities. Here is space given and you have to draw it. Now the next topic is economic condition of people. Economic condition of people also decides the type of house a person lives in. In villages, people with low income build small houses with materials like mud, straw and bamboo. People with high income build bigger houses or pakka houses or even bungalows containing many rooms and huge open spaces. Here you can see different types of houses. Now the fascinating fact. Hut is the most common type of house seen in a village. Students, have you ever visited a village and seen a hut? In cities, people with very less income live in slums. These areas have a large number of people living in very small buildings. Buildings are not properly repaired and lack basic facilities. Let's find out what are apartments or flats. Next topic is some special kinds of houses. Some areas are prone to earthquake. People in such parts live in houses made of wood and bamboos. There is less damage to life in case of an earthquake. These houses are also easier and less expensive to build. Some people use house on wheels called caravans to travel from one place to another. Next is, some people move from place to place. They live in tents made of canvas or nylon. Tents are temporary houses. Houses on lakes and other water bodies called houseboats are floating houses. They are used for various purposes. Such houseboats can be seen in Srinagar and Kerala in India. So students, In this way, you can see different types of houses. Next is living together. All of us live together with our family members in a house. Our house is built in a particular area. The area around our house is called our neighborhood. The people living in our neighborhood are called our neighbors. Living in harmony with our neighbors is a good thing. We should share our joys and sorrows with them. We should help each other in time of need. Now the activity, visit a neighbor's house and find out answers for the following questions. Here are some questions and you have to answer them accordingly. Thank you students, that's all from this chapter. We will meet again. Till then, bye-bye.